Victor Robertson, who we really don't know all that much about. We know that he finished seventh in the Australian title 2 weeks ago. He's in the lead. Look at this lead here. Peter Robertson, the lone figure out by himself. What a shock this would be if Robbo could get up. It's certainly one of the biggest shocks in Australian triathlon history. Peter Robertson, he's gone from pauper to prince in the space of the last 2 hours. He wins the Sydney World Cup. He wins the greatest prize in Australian triathlon because he is in the Australian Olympic team.
Right now, Peter Robertson going where he always strives, and that is to the front of the field. And right now, he makes the pass, and for the first time today, the Australian, Peter Robertson, the 27-year-old, in the lead here at the Gamagori World Cup Triathlon.
And what a race we have on our hands. Peter Robertson, the bolter, has come from the tail end of the field, and he is now past Paul Amy, and he's leading.
Best triathletes in the Commonwealth, indeed some of the best in the world. They're here, the crowd lift.
Well, Peter Robertson flying up to Brad Calderfeld. Aussie's 1-2 at the moment. And bang, Robbo is famous for his speed at the start of the run. And this is why, look at him go. Brad Calderfeld dropping back there a little bit. Hamish Carter hanging on to third place. Peter Robertson not waiting around for anything.
As we pull back to reveal the leaders now, four cyclists have made the break on the bike, the 40K bike ride. And there you can see them: Miles Stewart, Chris McCormack, Peter Robertson, and Richard Stannard. Leading the men out of the transition area and onto the 10K run course is Richard Stannard of Great Britain.
I don't anticipate that Stannard is going to stay there long. The person who's likely to take off like a bolt is Peter Robertson.
What a great moment this must be for somebody like Peter Robertson, who has overcome adversity to get to this level. Peter Robertson, the final meters now in this World Triathlon Championship. He was 34th at the Olympics. He was runner-up at the Worlds last year. He is just feeding off this tremendous crowd here at the finish line. Look, he's even turning his back on the line. But it is Australian Peter Robertson winning the World Championship for 2001. His time, 1 hour, 48 minutes, and 1 second.
I mean, even Robbo looks strong today. I've never seen him look like this, and it's amazing.
A little cheeky because he might run away from Olivia, but see how quick that is. That is absolutely amazing. That is a 1.5 second transition. Incredible. It was absolutely incredible. I don't think I've ever seen one faster than that.
Doing it again, turns around, he's going backwards. He's got Rania in the background there. But Peter Robertson, a little jig of delight, crosses the line. He is the 2003 world champion.
Traces of a good luck academy.
Peter Robertson now going to the lead, and he has exerted the same kind of style that we have seen him do on so many occasions. Sprint off, surge at the front, see how many athletes he can break. As Robertson has opened up already a 15-second lead on a chase group of the who's who and the men on the I2 World Cup circuit. Less than a kilometer from the finishing line. Peter Robertson trying desperately now to just lift those arms and legs, but you can see the fatigue. His arms are not nearly coming up. He's looking over his shoulder. That is not a good sign. Robertson now 100 meters to go to the finishing line. It looks like he has timed his energy and that red line ability to the finest as Peter Robertson coming to the finishing line, and Rito Hugh will have timed it just a little short. Robertson will claim his third world championships here in Gamagori, Japan. That is unbelievable.
Today was something special. It wasn't a physical performance. It was more than that. It was emotional. I had to dig deep. I've never hurt like that before. I was absolutely exhausted coming down the finish chute. I was just didn't want to get past. It meant too much to me today, and I'm really glad I hung on for an amazing victory. I've learned a lot this year about winning, losing, family, friends, life, death. So every day is special, and every day with my family is even more special. I knew I could do it. I knew it would be tough. I guess I wanted it more than anyone else.
Robbo was just too strong today. I mean, the guy's an absolute champion. He's three times world champion. I mean, he's going to go down in history as one of the best.